G to the 3, I'm international. Come out for me. I'm hopping this whip. Construct stuff for me.
Jay made the motherfucking slap.
Put this Glock in your name, bitch. It's 9 to 10. But I need whole money. G to the 3. I'm international. Come hold for me. Come hop in this whip. Crush all this dope for me. Is you gay? Can you strip? You gon' beat that road for me? Get on my mat. Do she get whole money? Hey, you caught a case and kept quiet for your folks, honey? I'ma do the dash to the cash like a roadrunner. Skit at the skit on my mama. I need all honey. He chased me down, so I walked him down. That's fair game. This Glock hella cute. Before I shoot, she say my name is Chick on a bareback.
Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today's video is gonna be like a little skincare, nighttime routine, feminine hygiene. If you feel me, it's gonna be one of those nights. Yeah, so honestly, we just gonna get straight into it. Normally, I would do everything in the shower because I'm fucking lazy, but I can't take y'all with me in the shower, so I'm gonna do everything outside of the shower and show you guys my products. And honestly, we're just gonna get straight into the video. So I normally brush my teeth first, and y'all should know by now, Sensodyne is my shit. Cause I have sensitive teeth, like especially in the front. Sensodyne always comes through. And I think I have one that's open though. Yeah, I have an open one. Y'all see, I just be buying random ones. As long as it says Sensodyne though, like that shit is good. This one is the complete protection, and this one is full protection plus whitening. And this one's just extra fresh. But yeah, I'm gonna just start off with brushing my teeth. I'm not sure if y'all wanna see that, but whatever. Do y'all wet y'all brush twice? I have to. I got a tongue scraper as well, tongue brush. I don't know what the fuck it's called. I actually just started to use this. Don't judge me. And y'all, like, I don't know how motherfuckers do this, because every time I do it, bitch, I am gagging. This is a mouthwash I use. Just some regular cheap shit. Nothing, you feel me? Nothing too fancy. I use these to floss with. I have regular floss, but with braces, it's just so much more difficult, and these are easy. So, okay, now that we're done with oral, we're gonna get into my skincare. And y'all, if you're OG, you should already know my skincare. It honestly has not changed. I still use African black soap. I have it in a little container here. I'm not gonna show y'all because it looked crazy, but yeah, just know it's African black soap. And I still use my little spin brush. So yeah, I fucked up my skin twice last year on some dumb shit, but as you can see, it came back. I got it back right. I was taking, what is it called? I was taking fish oil pills. Cause it's supposed to, like, I don't know, it's supposed to help your body or whatever. And so I was taking fish oil pills the first time, and it just completely fucked my skin up. Like, I was breaking out so much from it. So I stopped taking those. And then the second time I fucked up my skin, I was taking these biotin pills. And y'all, I've always taken biotin pills, but I always take the dissolvable ones. And I've been taking the dissolvable ones for like 3, 4, 5 years now, and I've never had an issue. But as soon as, I think Walmart didn't have the dissolvable ones at the time, so I got the gummies. And so I started taking the gummies, and y'all, my skin, it was not feeling it at all. Like, you know what it was? Because since it was 5,000 and I'm just used to taking 10,000, I was taking 2 a day, and I think that's what fucked me up. I should have stuck to 1 every other day or 1 a day, because that 2 a day, like, it fucked my skin completely up. You guys can honestly go see, like, my old video. You can go watch my old videos and see my skin was, like, terrible. Like, my Miami video, my Truth or Drink video, all my videos with gang. Like, my skin was fucked. And normally, I would exfoliate, which I am gonna do, but I'm gonna do that in the shower. So what I'm gonna do is put on Noxzema. Y'all know I love Noxzema, and honestly I'm gonna just leave it on here as a face mask while I'm in the shower. And yeah, honestly, I'll just leave. Sometimes I leave this on overnight as well. If I don't feel like doing my whole skincare routine, I'll just fall asleep with this on. And y'all, it does wonders. Just gonna leave this on throughout my entire time in the shower. And once I'm done with my whole skincare, my body care routine in the shower, then I'll rinse this off. And I'm also going to exfoliate with this St. Ives Acne Control Scrub. If you watched my first ever video, you know this is my shit. But yeah, so I'm gonna exfoliate with this, but in the shower, because yeah, I don't have time to be doing all that right now. So yeah, honestly y'all, that's basically it for that. So yeah, let's just get into the shower routine, because I'm finna hop in the shower. So I have this little African body scrub thing. I don't know what the fuck it's called, but I got it on Amazon, and it's supposed to like exfoliate your body. So I use this, and then it opens up long so that you can like put it behind you and like wash your back. And then I only shave my legs and my underarms, so I use the little cheapy razors, okay? And then I get my coochie waxed. I don't know if I can say that. I get her waxed, so don't have to worry about that. For her, I use the Honey Pot. It's a sensitive foaming wash, plant-based. It's, yeah, the Honey Pot. Let me see if I can see this. And then also with that, because I do get waxed, I have to exfoliate so that, you know, you don't get like ingrown hairs and like crazy shit like that. So I have this body polish that I actually get from the wax place, which is like $30 fucking. And then for my whole body, I use this rose water, sea salt, scrub, and wash. I really love the way it smells. It smells so good, y'all. And this is another one I use, the Love Beauty and Plant. This one also smells amazing. It smells so fucking good. And then I use this Aveeno. It's Skin Relief Body Wash, smooths itchy dry skin. So yeah, I'ma keep it G with y'all. I do use two body washes every time I shower, mainly because this one exfoliates and it smells good. And then this one actually does what it's supposed to do. You get what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, does that make sense? So yeah, this is like a gentle wash that I love. And then I would either do these two, I'll alternate between these two. I exfoliate my whole entire body with Tree Hut. This is new, I just bought this one. There's this other one that I normally get. I think it's like brown sugar, it's something. But I ran out, and when I went to the store, this is literally the only one they had. They only had vitamin C, the vitamin C one left. So I just decided to try this one. And honestly y'all, I'm gonna keep it G. I use whatever conditioner in the shower I have to shave with. Like, I don't buy shaving cream, I just use conditioner. So whatever conditioner we got in the in there is what I use. Like, we have this coconut one, so I'll just rub this on my underarms and my legs and then shave, because conditioner does the trick, y'all. So yeah, that's basically it for my shower routine. So I'm about to get in the shower and use all this. And yes you guys, I use every single one of these items. All right, I need to put my hair in a bun. Forgot to do that. I'm so ready to take these braids out, y'all, but as much money as I fucking paid for them, these motherfuckers gotta stay in at least another month. At least another month before I take them out, because no. But yeah, and normally I would wear my bonnet, but I don't think I need to with these braids. I don't really mind if they get wet, and besides, they're not gonna get that way anyways. So yeah, But yeah, so that's how I do my hair for when I'm about to get in the shower. So yeah. Oh shit, I forgot a braid. Alright guys, we fresh out the shower. I had to touch up my edges because I can't be on here looking too crazy now. First thing that I do, oh my god, this is gonna piss me off. The first thing that I do when I get out of the shower is chapstick. You feel me? Because my lips be chapped as fuck. Cotton pads and then witch hazel. Y'all should know by now. Witch hazel is the holy grail. And then I just take off the excess dirt. Bruh, I don't know if I even told y'all. I don't work at Chick-fil-A anymore. I quit. I don't remember if I said that in a video or not. I'm pretty sure I have. But if not, then yeah, guys. I don't work there anymore. It's a little bittersweet. It's actually a relief when I put my 2-week notice in. But I tell y'all, putting my 2-week notice in was like one of the hardest things ever for some reason. Like, I don't know what the fuck. I use CeraVe for, what is this, eye repair cream. Because, you know, I'm not trying to have crow's feet. I'm not trying to look old when I'm older. If that makes sense. So, yeah, eye cream, baby. When I would go to work, I would literally, when I would go to Chick-fil-A, I would literally, my whole inner, like, my whole vibe would just change. My energy would just be down. I hated being there. It was just to the point, like, I would walk in and then just my whole mood would change. I could not stand being there at all. Yet I couldn't put my fucking 2-week notice in for some reason. Like, I don't know what it is, but I have like this weird attachment to jobs. I don't know why. It's weird because I ain't never been attached to no nigga, but I be attached to jobs. I would just like, I hated the feeling that I felt when I would go there. And then I use this benzoyl peroxide from acne.org. y'all, if y'all got fucked up skin, acne.org will help you. Okay, it helped me, and it helped me kind of figure out my skin type and what I needed to do. A lot of trial and tribulation, trial and error, whatever it's called. But yeah, I just hated being there, and like, I would just be so relieved to be off. And y'all, I would only be there 3 days out of the week. Once I got my other job, I was only there for like 3 days out of the week, and I was only there 5 hours tops each day. I don't know, y'all. I was just trying to push through it. I would go to work and I would hate it, but then I'd come home and I'd be like, it was only 5 hours. It wasn't that bad. I'm basically getting paid to do nothing. Like, what am I complaining about? Like, what am I stressing over? I also use this AHA. It's 10%. I don't know. A little bit, because this shit burns. Especially after you exfoliate, this shit burns like a motherfucker. I kept wanting to put my 2-week notice in. Like, I would go to work and just be hating life and be like, I'm putting my fucking 2-week notice in. I'm done. I'm over this. And I would get off work and then I'd talk myself out of it. Like, girl, this is an easy ass job. You only had to do 5 hours. What are you complaining about? It's easy money. Like, you basically go in there doing nothing and getting paid. Like, I kept talking myself out of it despite how I felt. I use this too, y'all. This got a whole bunch of shit in it, and I'm almost out. But a bitch bought another one. I don't feel like opening it right now. I'm trying to use all this because this shit is $14. But like, go to work. I would talk myself out of it despite how I felt, despite how irritated I was. Like, any little thing would piss me off. I did not want to be there. It just, it wasn't working out. But I kept talking myself out of it. Like, I don't know why, y'all. Like, I had to literally be at work and let myself feel every emotion that I was feeling. I had to let myself go through everything I was going through. I had to physically feel everything in order for me to put my two-week notice in. I literally had to put my 2-week notice in when I was at work. Because, y'all, I'm gonna keep it G. I had my 2-week notice written up for about a month now, and I just been procrastinating just because I couldn't bring myself to do it for some weird fucking reason. I don't know, y'all. I had to literally take my ass to work and let myself feel everything. Let myself be irritated, let myself be frustrated, I had to let myself feel every emotion so that instantly when I went on my break, I can send my 2-week notice in and feel absolutely nothing. I literally had to do that because I'm a fucking weirdo. I don't know, y'all. And then I think another part of me wasn't trying to quit either, because after I got my other job, it just wasn't, I don't know, it just, it wasn't it. I use this to moisturize, guys. Y'all know what this is. Once I got another job, I wanted to feel secure financially. I wanted to feel happy with what I was doing, you know? I mean, it's not my career field. So either way, I wasn't gonna be, you know, it was just, at the end of the day, it was just gonna be a job. So I wasn't gonna be too happy. I just wanted to be happier than what I was at, you know, Chick-fil-A. So I think that also played like a huge part in me not wanting to quit, because yeah, I'm working two jobs and my check is not adding up to what it should be. For me to be have working two jobs, my check should have been this and that, and it wasn't given that. You feel me? Like, I at that point, it was just like, it just wasn't making sense. So I'm like, I'm literally slaving for basically nothing. So I'm like, one of these jobs gotta go. You feel me? And then I wanted to feel like secure before I officially quit at Chick-fil-A, and I wasn't feeling secure at all. So that also played like a huge part in me not wanting to put my 2 week notice in, y'all. I also put aloe vera gel wherever I shave at so that I don't get like razor bumps and stuff. So I'm gonna put it on my underarms. And then I just bought this one that I decided to try. This one is, I think it's, yeah, it's pure vitamin E oil. So yeah, let me try this. This is my first time using this, so I'm gonna put a little bit on, because this one's I haven't used before. I bought new toothbrush because I needed a new toothbrush. It came with two. That's the one I was using in the bathroom. But yeah, y'all, I always buy new toothbrushes like once. I probably should do it once a month. Mascara and some Easy Breezy Brows. It's clear brow gel. And I bought matte. Y'all, I don't wear makeup, but I used to wear eyelash extensions, and it fucked my lashes up. Like, my lashes used to be, like, if you go watch my old videos, you'll see. My lashes used to be nice, and, like, now they're all, I don't know if you can see, but they're fucked up because of lash extensions. So I decided to try mascara as a replacement, so hopefully that looks good. And then I got brow gel just because I don't get my brows done. They're just naturally fucking thin, and yeah, I tried to grow them thicker, but y'all, this is as thick as it's gonna get. Yeah, my natural brows are just fucking thin, so at least I can do is shape them and keep trying to hold them in place. So yeah, that's why I bought this. This is the coconut coffee body cream. This shit, it smells so good. If you like the smell of coffee, you would love this. I can smell this all day. But you know, Jergens always get you right. So yeah, I'm just gonna lotion my whole body with Jergens. I don't really think y'all wanna see that, so I'll be back. Okay, I lotioned up, I'm all oily, and I got my cute little PJs on. Deodorant. This is the deodorant I use. Nothing special, y'all. Okay, I also bought this castor oil. I've had this for a while. Can y'all see it? I've had it for a while. It gives you longer lashes and thicker brows. But like I told y'all, this is as thick as my brows are getting. So yeah, I still try to put castor oil on them. There's none on here. I'm just separating. But yeah, it's supposed to help your lashes grow long. So yeah, that's what I've been using. And yeah, I think that's it. Oh, and I also wanted to show y'all this. Once I finish my skincare routine, I spray my face with some rose water. And then also, if I don't get everything shaved properly in the shower, you know how you miss a step? I got this little electric shaver. I usually carry it in my purse, but now that I switched purses and it's small, I just have it at home. But yeah, y'all, you know when you miss a spot, you gotta go back, miss a little, get you an electric shaver, y'all. It's a fucking one. I ate earlier, so I've already taken some of these, but I'm gonna just show y'all. So I have these Biotin's coconut oil that I got on Amazon. And then I also take cranberry pills. I usually get the chewables just because I like the chewables. Those shits taste good to me. I have vitamin E oil pills. Vitamin E supplement, sorry. that I take. So I already took these three. I usually take the pills right after I eat, and I ate earlier, so I already took these three. I also take zinc, which I'm probably gonna take right now. I take prenatal. I take prenatal vitamins. It has minerals and DHA. I usually take these prenatal vitamins, but I started taking them, and then I would notice I would get a breakout. So I slowed down on them. So I only take them once a week. I take them after I eat, and I drink plenty of water, because y'all, when I seen that breakout, I had a complete no. I don't play when it comes to my skin. So yeah, with prenatal vitamins, this shit is tricky. So I only take this once a week. It says you can take it once a day, but bitch, I'm not breaking out for nobody. I don't give a fuck. Y'all wanna see my little cute pajamas? I'm trying to get a cute little... Okay, so now we're gonna get into my hair care. And then honestly, I think that completes it. But I did want to show y'all my cute little slippers, y'all. My mom got me these for Christmas. And yeah, they're so cute. So I'm going to put these on and be cozy. Okay, and we're back in the bathroom. So I'm going to make this quick because it is 10:38 and I want to go lay down. But somebody actually recommended this to me. So I bought this on Amazon, and yeah, I've been using it ever since. So far, this should just make my head fucking itch like crazy. I use these as well. You can find these at Walmart, and I just pour the Jamaican black castor oil in this applicator, and yeah, that's what I use so that I could easily apply it to my scalp. But yeah, I just kind of run it down. I get my edges because the bitch is almost bald. My edges on, and it's only on one side, y'all. My right side edges are just fucking terrible. And then once I do that, I just kind of rub it into my scalp. Massage my scalp. Y'all know I'm black, so I use grease, okay? We got this Indian hemp one, though. I'll give y'all an up close of my skin, but yeah. So this is what everything looks like. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know if y'all got some products for eyelashes or eyebrows or anything. Let a bitch know, because I need help with that department.